nipple discharge. Before starting the abnormal nipple discharge, we know the general anatomy of the breast. First of all, this is the nipple. Now, this is the fat cell which fill in the cavity of the breast. Now, this is the mammary gland which common in the vertebrates, and this is the lactiferous duct. Now, this green part is the cut section of the ribs, and this green part is the pectoralis muscles. Now, these all the structure is covered with the skin. It is the general anatomy of the breast. Now we are going to discuss the abnormal nipple discharge. Now discuss the nipple discharge. Nipple discharge is the one of the most common symptom of the breast cancer, or we know that the breast cancer is the most common cancer in the woman. Now discuss the nipple discharge. If the nipple discharge is unilateral, spontaneous and serous discharge from the single duct, is generally due to the intraductal papilloma. And what is the intraductal papilloma, we discuss further, but it is the benign carcinoma. It occurs in the lactiferous duct. We discuss further what is the intraductal papilloma, how the treatment of the intraductal papilloma is occurs. But mostly the nipple discharge is due to the duct papilloma and duct ectasia. Most common cause of the nipple discharge is duct papilloma and duct ectasia. And what is the duct ectasia, we discuss further, in which the inflammation of the lactiferous duct tubules occurs. It form the polyplaque structure in which the fluid serous fluid are secreted from the many colorful fluid from secreted from the nipples. We discuss further, but the chances of malignancy is high if the person suffer from the nipple discharge. Now the type of the discharge and the cause of the discharge we discuss. Blood stain. If the discharge of the nipple contain the blood stain, then it's due to the duct papilloma, intraductal carcinoma and duct ectasia. Duct papilloma, intraductal carcinoma and duct ectasia. And duct papilloma is the most common cause of the blood stain, nipple discharge. And serous discharge is due to the fibrocystic disease. We discuss further what is the fibrocystic disease and duct ectasia and carcinoma. And it is the most, we know that black, green and paste like discharge if occur from the nipple, it due to the duct ectasia. Most common blood stain if the occurs, it is the most common cause is the duct papilloma, and intraductal carcinoma is also occurs, but the most common cause is the duct papilloma. And serous discharge is most common fibrocystic disease. And if the colorful nipple discharge occurs, the most common is now discuss the intraductal papilloma. Intraductal papilloma is the benign carcinoma which generally occurs near the areola region. It is the occurs in the duct of the mammary gland. It is the benign carcinoma. And intraductal papilloma is the most common cause of the blood stain discharge from the nipple. It is the most common, and the treatment of the intraductal carcinoma is microdecectomy. what is the microtachycotomy? In this, the this part of the cancer and along with the duct is excision occurs. Surgery of the duct, affected duct, along with the whole tumor occurs in the microtachycotomy. And next one is ductectasia, and the next one is ductectasia. Ductectasia is the inflammatory condition of the lactiferous duct in which the inflammation of the lactiferous duct occurs due to the serous discharge, colorful serous discharge, black, green, paste like discharge occurs due to the ductectasia. And the treatment of the ductectasia is the Hadfield operation, and also the antibiotic treatment is done. In this, the lactiferous duct is inflamed due to the fluid does not pass from the duct, and it causes the abscess, breast abscess formation occurs in the ductectasia. And treatment is the Hadfield operation, also the